So you want to hit legend as fast as possible. You want to wrap up super fast. And if that's the case, you came to the right person. Now, Christmas noobs, you missed out on Puma Mania twice. That's the easiest way to wrap up right there, is to play Puma Mania. But I got y'all. Y'all see it in these clips right here, man. Alley-oops, 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 and some flashy passes here and there. But flashy passes are pretty inconsistent, even with the Hall of Fame badge. Alley-oops are much more effective. All you do is you go baseline, get someone to cut, make sure he doesn't get bumped, and double tap Y or double tap triangle, depending on if you're Xbox or PS4. If you're PC or Nintendo Switch, then I'm afraid I can't help you because I have no idea what the controls are. But yeah, for alley-oops, going baseline is the most effective way to get lobs because it creates really good angles. You can get them from the wing or the top of the key, but the problem is it's inconsistent. Sometimes the cutter could run at a bad angle, or sometimes it's just a bad angle, period. Or it causes bad animations, such as your center just dropping the pass for no reason. Or it could be a good angle and good pass, but the game will just make the ball get thrown out of bounds anyway. But the baseline, it's nearly a completion every single time. You can also do it off the cut. Obviously, make sure the cut is open. There's no chance of him getting bumped. Make sure there's no weak side help to steal the pass. Obviously, you're not going to be playing the best players when doing this. You see the players I'm playing against in these clips, they are not the best players. You're only primarily going to be able to rep farm like this against bumps. You might be able to do this against average players on certain plays where they overplay you on the shot and the cutter's wide open for a lob. Take that every time. I'm going to show you the points you get. Look at how much rep you get for this. Look at the alley-oops, look at the flashies. Alley-oops are worth 1,400 per. It's also worth noting that it caps off at, I think, 4 or 5. After that, they won't count anymore. So once you get your lobs, try flashy assists if you're playing people that just can't score against you. They have no shot in hell at beating you. Just mess around and try and get your rep. Because opponent strength doesn't really mean nothing when you're getting a bunch of alley-oops and flashies. You will get tons of points. You see, I'm getting 11, 12, 13k against guys that don't really give me opponent strength. And the guys that you play that do get you opponent strength, you're going to get plenty of points off their opponent strength alone, plus your win bonus if you beat them. And, you know, scoring plus the opponent strength, you know, it makes up for it. But that's pretty much it. Flashies, alley-oops. Go baseline as much as you can, and backdoor cuts, transition, that's all very important. But that's all I got for you. If you want to see me hit Superstar 1, link in the description. And I got plenty of great content coming. We got big things in 2020. This is a tutorial. I'm not trying to be the most entertaining in this video. I just want to help you guys out. I got plenty more entertaining videos besides this. So make sure you check them out. And make sure you subscribe so you can see what comes next. I got some big things on the way, like I said. But till next time, I'm out. Peace.